Hello, I'm Rob Hirschfeld, CEO and co-founder of RackN, and this video is about installing Digital Rebar for the first time. We call it DRP, and you'll hear me use that term throughout the videos. There are three different ways that we're going to cover for this first install process: isolated, virtual, and cloud. They all have the same basic setup, so we're going to show you that process in slides, and then we'll have special videos for each one. So make sure you're watching the right video for your environment. If you're not sure which one, hang on. We're going to talk about which one is which. No matter which install process you're using, it's all pretty much the same thing. You download Digital Rebar from the infrastructure as code catalog. You connect it to the infrastructure you want, and then you'll explore our full catalog and do more advanced things. Those obviously are outside the scope of this video. So for your first Digital Rebar install video, you need to choose how you want to approach it. The simplest is to do a Digital Rebar on your desktop. This means actually running the service on your desktop itself. We have a special mode for that that doesn't set it up as a permanent service. And that's a really nice way to get started, but it requires a Linux or a Mac desktop. It does use less resources, and it's an excellent quick start. It's sort of our history quick start. The other choice is to just run Digital Rebar in a virtual machine and then use that to provision other virtual machines. This works really well for Windows desktops. If you have a virtual cluster that you can use as a dedicated infrastructure, or you don't want to have any impact on your desktop at all, it uses more resources and RAM because you have to run a VM for Digital Rebar, but it doesn't leave any trail. You can just delete those VMs. And then finally, Digital Rebar in the cloud is the newest addition to the Digital Rebar install family, where you set everything up using cloud infrastructure. Now, that won't let you test pixie booting and machine provisioning, but it does let you play with all of the infrastructure's code capabilities, our Kubernetes and K3S capabilities, and build your own content packs, play with our multi-cloud and distributed cloud infrastructure. So it's a lot of advanced functionality that works great using the cloud infrastructure, and Digital Rebar works just fine in those cases also. So let's get to it. In the Digital Rebar on your desktop, this is the environment that we're going to set up. We'll install Digital Rebar, and then we'll build the virtual machines in a host-only network so we can pixie boot them. We turn off DHCP in the VirtualBox or VMware system because Digital Rebar provides the DHCP system. It will only talk to that, bind it to only talk to that network. So everything will work just fine. And we'll walk you through this process if this is your path. The Digital Rebar and virtual machine is very similar to that process, except instead of running it on your desktop, we have to set up a virtual machine first. Usually a CentOS machine is a good choice with 4 gigs of RAM, and then attach that to the NAT network so you can download Digital Rebar and the host-only network so you can pixie boot VMs. This actually is a bridged situation, works very well. Just requires a little bit more setup and more RAM on the system that's running the demo. And the final is DRP in the cloud. In that case, you actually provision a machine in the cloud using the cloud infrastructure. You open port 8092, the Digital Rebar API port, and then you install Cloud Wrapper. And Cloud Wrapper will automate the process of provisioning and connecting to other virtual machines in the cloud or other clouds if you want, and connect all those together. So all three of these processes have the same basic step. They download our install.sh from getrebar.digital, they make it installable, and then they run the install.sh with install as the criteria. The difference in the isolated mode is that you actually tell it that you want an isolated system. You ask for the version you want, usually tip or stable, depending on your level of interest in pulling in the latest things or just playing around with the last release. And then in this isolated version, you have to start Digital Rebar provision, DR provision, yourself. That means you have to tell it where the files are going to be. You have to identify that it's a start to start the runner and create itself. In the cloud and VM models, you can run it as a systemd process. Of course, you could do that on your desktop too. You're welcome to. But when you run install.sh and pass in systemd and tell it to start up, it will actually install as a systemd process and start it. So you pass in the parameters here and they get built into the systemd definition. Very similar processes, but if you are able to just have a dedicated machine for Digital Rebar, it's super easy to just use the systemd install. Once it's installed and running, and you shouldn't have to SSH into the cloud boxes if you pass in a bootstrapping script, then the first thing you're going to need to do is accept the TLS certificate. So you'll go into the machine's IP, :8092. It will accept the certificate and then redirect you to the Digital Rebar UX, the hosted one. Now, none of the traffic is actually coming to RackN. You are downloading a single page app in React, which is our UX, from RackN.io, and then connecting directly to your Digital Rebar. We don't cross your networks. We don't open firewall ports. We don't send traffic. We are not in the control loop. We're just providing the UX. Once you log in with the password that you chose, or the default one if you didn't set a password, Rocket Skates is the default, R0CKETSK8TS. It will prompt you if you hover over the question mark. The next step to do is to get a free trial license. This will enable all of the features that we are going to install and download as part of the trials, including the cloud wrapper pieces, which does require a license to fully enable. Provide a password. This process is changing, so if you're watching this video, this is the old process that we're showing where you give an email, you wait for a token and come back. The new process eliminates those steps and you will be able to just provide information that you feel comfortable providing, and then it will grant you a short-term license immediately. From there, if you want to go to the system information and follow the bootstrapping wizard. The bootstrapping wizard is designed to make sure that you have configured all of the pieces and parts necessary to have a great trial experience. That includes making sure your passwords are set, setting the base content, making sure that you've uploaded the ISOs and boot environments, subnet definitions. If you're in cloud, you don't need to worry about subnet definitions, preferences, SSH keys, and then finally starting machines. So this walks you through that. As you accomplish each step, you'll see a checkbox. If you click on the words, the link words, they will take you to the place you need to go to get that step done. And then finally, in this demo, we are always encouraging you to use our bootstrap system, which means Digital Rebar is actually running an agent on itself, and it can provide the bootstrapping processes automatically for you. We use this for zero touch remote edge installs, and it's really, really convenient. And so we are recommending that for your first experience. Once you have this demo installed, then what you can do is literally run through the bootstrapping process on the machine, and it will do all the setups that need to be done automatically for you. So let's install Digital Rebar in the cloud. While we might be well known for physical provisioning and automation, the work I'm going to show you lets you run Digital Rebar and play with our infrastructure as code in any cloud. I'm going to be doing this in Amazon, but you can follow these steps in any cloud infrastructure, and the cloud wrapper workflows work across the board also. And we have videos that show you how to adapt and extend those. We're going to be using that as part of this process here. So I just went to launch. I'm going to go ahead and pick an Amazon Linux instance. 4 gigs of RAM is more than sufficient for this. For the instance details, what I want to do is all these are fine, but I also want to go ahead and add a Digital Rebar install script over here. So this is going to download the install.sh file, set it to executable, and then run install.sh with systemd. We're going to tell it to start up and start runner. That's going to allow us to avoid having to SSH in and do any additional installation steps on the box. And we're going to use the tip install. So I'm going to get the latest code in this case. I'm also going to set a value cloud provider to unknown. That's sort of a hint that tells the system to not bother trying to install the Pixieboot ISOs, discovery images, and things like that. That'll save us a bit of time. And I'm going to set the password to demo. So I have a command in here that sets users Rocket Skates password to password. So since I'm in the public cloud and it's an open endpoint and I'm going to install credentials, I never want to have the default passwords here. I want to change that. So that looks great. That will allow it to work completely automatic once I launch the instance. Storage is fine. I'm going to go ahead and put a name, and I'll just call it Cloud Demo. That looks great. For my security group, I'm going to want to, I have some existing ones. Here's my training demo. And you would just add your own. I need TCP to be open on port 8092. That's the Digital Rebar API port. And it's useful to also pick 8091, which is our unsecured TCP port. The API doesn't work here, but files and templates, cloud init, things like that can be passed through in HTTP mode on 8091 also. And there's some scripts that rely on that. Not required, but depending on what you want to practice, have it open, and that'll make things easier for you. This is everything I've pretty much done. Doesn't require a lot of work to do. And of course, it's always nice to have a key on the system. I won't need to SSH into the box, but we should be ready to go. And now if I jump over into viewing my instances, you'll see I have two cloud demos. I set one up because I wanted to go ahead and jump right into the demo without having to wait. So we're going to go in and check my system log, see if that's done yet. It is. And if I look at my system log, what you'll see as I get down at the bottom, it started the Digital Rebar install. That's down way near the bottom. This is the checks completing, Digital Rebar getting set up, all of the installs and pieces like that. So this is a quick check to just verify that Digital Rebar is working and running the commands and everything is going great. So on this system here, I have Digital Rebar running. I'm going to go ahead and grab that IP address, go to HTTPS, the IP address 8092, Digital Rebar's API port. Because I haven't touched this system before, it has a self-signed certificate by default. And what we're going to do is go ahead and accept that certificate. And that will take me to automatic login to the Rackend portal. That looks great. In this instance, I'm going to use the newest API, which is TIP instead of portal. You can see I've done this before. If I come in and here, I'll just go to TIP. So if I do that, I can put in my IP address here, go ahead and run it, provide my password. Remember, I use demo for my password. Don't need to save it. I accept the license. And this is the Digital Rebar machine that I just server that I just set up. And showing me my bootstrapping wizard. So there's a couple things here like Sledgehammer, ISOs for boot environments, subnets that I absolutely don't need in the cloud. I'm not doing any discovery or pixie provisioning. But there are some normal steps that we're going to go through. For example, I want to upload my SSH key. Our workflows will install that for me, and it's super handy to have my root credentials set up automatically. And I also want to go into my license manager. This screen is about to change. If you're seeing this version of it, then you'll need to create an account, log in, and authorize your endpoint. For me, I already have a valid license file, so I'm just going to upload that license file and then check an update, which is going to register the system. If you're doing this with the new process, this should walk right through or ask you for that file all in the first step if your endpoint isn't licensed yet. So we keep streamlining this process and trying making it easier and easier. So now I've got my system just about ready to go. My preferences will get set by running my provisioning workflow, my bootstrapping workflow, and I will show you that in a minute. But before we do, I need to go and install the cloud content. To do that, I need to get my Docker context installed. Looks good. And I also need my cloud wrapper install. And what you'll notice here is that since I'm using the TIP, I'm going to go ahead and pull in the TIP versions instead of the stable versions. By the time this is released, 4.6 should be used. You see this, 4.6 will probably be out, and you can just use the 4.6 release components, and that should be good enough. So now that I have my Docker context and cloud wrapper, those are cloud-specific workflows and capabilities that allow us to run Terraform and Ansible in containers in the Digital Rebar server. That's a standard workflow that we use that we can do cloud provisioning with, and I'm about to demonstrate exactly how that works. Before I can, I do need to install Docker or Podman on the Digital Rebar server, and because of the bootstrapping system, literally runner, the agent, or what we call a runner, on Digital Rebar server, I can take advantage of that to do those installations for me. So I never have to SSH into the box. I can use our infrastructure as code models to bootstrap and build, and these can be very sophisticated workflows, literally pulled down as part of our infrastructure content package. And that's exactly what's happening here. If I click in to this task, you'll see that it's detected it didn't have Docker installed, and it's running in the Docker install service and getting everything set up. And then it's going to pull in and download the Docker containers that we need to run Digital Rebar CLI, Ansible, and Terraform. And it'll switch between those containers depending on the work that needs to get done. At this point, I'm pretty close to ready to having everything good to go. What I would need to do before I do any other action is I have to provide my credentials for those cloud machines. So if I come into here, I'd need a profile, and I'd want to add a profile that has my Amazon credentials. So I'd want to say my cloud provider. Excellent. Pick Amazon from the list. That looks really good. I'm going to save this. Now that's not enough to actually make it run. I need credentials. So those are stored securely, and I can only add them to an existing profile. So I had to create my profile, save it, and then I would come back to my AWS access key. Notice that would be a secure password here. I can put in something here. My AWS secret. We have comparable ones for any cloud that you would want to build, and I would do the same here. Save this, and now I have a profile that I can use to provision machines. Now, clearly didn't enter my key and secret, and those are sort of a pain to add here. You can certainly cut and paste it, but to make things a little bit easier, what we've done is added a script that will build those profiles based on your local cloud configuration files. So it'll pick them up, and then it'll build the profile with the information for multiple clouds all in one pass. To do that, what we'll need is the Digital Rebar CLI on the machine where I have those credentials. You can click over here and get information about the CLI, including downloading, or every Digital Rebar server includes the appropriate DRP CLI, and you can pick the one that's right for your architecture, download it, rename it to be DRP CLI, and you are good to go for using that. And I'm going to show you exactly what that looks like, because it's really handy to inject your profile like that. So in this case, I have the Digital Rebar provision content. Let me show you that script is actually in our open GitHub under Tools, Cloud Profiles, and then this runs through that process. Some of the steps that I did are actually automated as part of that process also, and I could have just used the Cloud Profile setup to do the content packs, Docker install, bootstrapping for me, and I could have skipped all those steps. I wanted you to see me doing it so that it wasn't too much magic, but that's about the way things should go. And to make DRP CLI work, first I have to set my endpoint, which I'm doing here, HTTPS. Let's see, does that right? That looks like the right endpoint. And since I changed the password, I need to change that from the default also. It's Rocket Skates is the user, Skates. And then I set demo as my password. And then I can test it, DRP CLI. Machines list, and I'm gonna JQ this just to show the name of the machine, and that returns the one machine I have in the list. I could also say DRP CLI info get if I wanted to look at the Digital Rebar servers, version information, content packs, all sorts of stuff is returned in here. That's super handy. So now that I can actually attach to that machine, I can just run this cloud profiles script and it will go through the whole process for me. So here it is making sure I have the prerequisites, doing the credentials. It's actually running the bootstrapping advanced server behind the scenes, which I've already run. And now it's collecting my credentials, building profiles for each one of those clouds that I could access, including like for Azure, it's actually using the CLI in Azure to collect the information it needs and build the correct profiles. So at this point we are done, and we should move this out of the way. Looks great. If I then go to provision machine, I can just create a machine here. We'll do an AWS demo one. I'm going to start that using my Digital Rebar CLI runner context. It has to have a context somewhere to start a workflow, and use the cloud provisioning workflow. That looks great. And I need to provide my AWS profiles. And let's see, so they are not showing up yet. Let me find out what happened because I ran those processes. Here is my AWS profile. That looks great. And you'll notice, should have gone here first, my cloud provider, just like I showed you. This one also included setting my user key because new machines from AWS don't have root. They use EC2 user. And then my credentials were also stored in here. I could define additional things if I wanted. So I could change the region that I'm dealing with, the size of the machine. There's a whole bunch of AWS instance types, AMI IDs and things like that. In this case, we're just going to stick with the defaults, and we have other videos explaining how to customize the Cloud Wrapper Terraform pieces to build whatever you want using your own custom Terraform templates and then pass those in and around Digital Rebar. So let's go back to provision, see if we can make this work. AWS demo one, Digital Rebar CLI runner, cloud provision workflow. I need my AWS profile. That looks much better. And I'm going to add the machine. You'll notice it immediately starts running. So since I gave it the startup criteria, it was able to start that context immediately and begin the cloud provisioning workflow. I'll show you what that looks like. It has a series of events that include jumping in and setting up the system. If I click in and actually watch the task, what you'll see here is we're literally running Terraform. So Digital Rebar server is running Terraform on our behalf. We're seeing a live log as it goes through this process, and we will store the Terraform automation information back on the system, generates the keys and makes everything go. And you can see we're getting live updates as the system runs through this process. This looks great. If I come over to my AWS console, that new AWS demo machine is now being built and is running through the process. That looks perfect. And now we're waiting for that machine. So it's transitioned from Terraform, now in doing Ansible. So it's running an Ansible playbook that will then SSH into the box and run the Digital Rebar agent and attach it to the system. So I've literally gone in now and built my infrastructure and made everything come up. So we're in this process. One of the things I can do that's also interesting, if you noticed, I have this create manually, but I also have a cloud provisioning system where I can use the profiles I've created. I'm going to call this a pool. So we're actually building a pool of machines. I'll call this one pool one. I don't need to add any profiles. It's going to take care of that. And let's see, don't know why it got confused. Let's say AWS pool one, add that machine. Oh, maybe I have a name here that I don't expect. Pool one. Let's seem to have gotten confused. There must be a bug in the UX on this. So in this case, I've built the pool. It's applied the profile for me automatically. I'm going to go ahead and provision a second one in AWS. And you'll note that as when it built it, it actually went through and identified all of the systems that I had available. Did it put it in the right pool? That's in pool cloud AWS. In this case, I need to assign this pool. Check what's going on with this. All right, rewind me back to just after I've created this first pool machine. I'm not going to create another pool. I'm just going to get this one up, and we're going to go through this process. So now that we've created this one machine in the pool, I can go through. It's already assigned in the profile, and if I allocate it in the pool operation is going to automatically start the cloud provision workflow. This is a very handy way to create machines. I can literally have machines that are ready to go, use our pool API to pull one out, provision it on the fly, and when you release it, it will deprovision it, and you'll see the system doing the opposite. So it's the exact same workflow that I'm showing you with cloud provision, but I can have machines ready to go, predefined with configuration parameters and other values, what region I want, what size I want, additional workflow tasks, and those will be performed automatically for me when I check them out of the pool and then release them. We actually have a Terraform provider that uses the pooling to provide these operations. If I come back over here, what you'll see is that here's the machines I've created in my Digital Rebar system. That's all looking great. One thing to note is since I've created these and added my key, I can also go back and SSH into those. I took the IP address, and since I provisioned it with Digital Rebar and it ran a full workflow, it also added the keys that I've assigned into my profiles. And so I now have access to them based on that. And you can assign keys like this at global, profile, or local machine levels so that you can actually have different teams with their keys injected correctly during the provisioning process just for them. All right, that looks great. So I'm done with that. These systems are provisioning. They're literally going through. The network firewall process is smart enough for Amazon that it will, and actually most of the cloud providers, it opens up the ports for the machine based on what your network firewall settings are at the profile level. So if you've defined a network configuration, it's going to open up the ports during the Terraform provisioning. That's how we're passing information back and forth. Let me show you what these look like on the machine data. So you'll see we've gone through, we've run our normal deep inventory scan and collected a lot of data that's available via the API. We've retrieved additional information, so the Terraform template runner will scan and pick up additional variables that you've defined as outputs. And then we've stored the Terraform state file. So any additional operations I take on the system will use this Terraform state file for this machine. And so the machine automation can go through multiple Terraform stages. It can pass information forward into Ansible or other tasks. It can retrieve them when we're doing cleanup and then do the appropriate levels of cleanup and teardown, which is exactly what we want to do next. So I'm going to go back over here. For the pool system, I can just go into pool, I can release this asset, and it's now going through a decommissioning process. It's going to do a Terraform cleanup and destroy the resources and clean up the variables assigned. For the one I created manually, I have to go through and actually deprovision the system. So that's fine. Same workflow. I'm just choosing to run it by hand instead of running it as a single system. Both of these are now going to go through. If we come into AWS and look at what's going on, you will see that they have they're getting shut down and released. That looks great. So you can see the systems that we have told it to decommission are being decommissioned, and we have released our resources back into the cloud. Very, very straightforward process. And the cloud provisioning and decommissioning workflows are just part of our standard library, easy to extend with whatever Terraform scripts or Ansible scripts you want to run or add into this process. So now that I've done that, this looks great. I can come back and now rotate systems through. If I want to allocate again, take this machine and use it for another user or reset it up and then take it through the workflow, all that stuff is automatic. And then because of our event-driven system, you can chain workflows together. You can watch for when workflow operations are finished. You can build downstream logic on it. You can also build workflow that tells the system to alert you or push notifications into you as additional steps coming from the Digital Rebar server or from the machine itself, of course. So that is it. We don't need to make this any more complex than it is. It's easy to install Digital Rebar in the cloud, and then it's very straightforward to use our cloud wrapper workflows to do provisioning and deprovisioning operations against any of the clouds that we support. And you saw with the script, I literally just pulled in my cloud credentials from 5 different clouds and made them available for provisioning. I hope this is something you want to give a try. We're really excited about all the ways that this controls infrastructure and how consistently we do automation between cloud, virtual, physical, edge, colo, on-premises, whatever you've got. We've been automating it with Digital Rebar, and we're looking forward to hearing from you and what you would like to do with it. Thanks.